Hello students. In the previous class, we have completed the chapter Structure of Atom. So let us begin with the new chapter today that comes under the Organic Chemistry, that is Organic Chemistry, Some Basic Principles and Techniques. This is the heading of the chapter. Okay, previously what we have studied is comes under Structure of Atom, comes under Inorganic Chemistry. Okay, then this chapter carries 11 marks. The weightage of this chapter is 11 marks. Okay, and 5 marks, 2 questions will be asked at the last part of the question paper. 5 marks, 2 questions. Those 5 mark questions may split again into 2 plus 3 or 2 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1, like that they can split. Okay, and 1 mark, 1 question will be asked in the part A. So totally weightage of this chapter is 11 marks. Okay. Then organic chemistry, some basic principles and techniques. Here in the previous classes, in the lower classes you have studied, the carbon has the unique property called catenation. Carbon has the unique property called as catenation. What do you mean by catenation? Okay, it is the unique property shown by the element carbon, and its capacity is capable of forming the covalent bonds with the other carbon atoms or any other atoms. Okay, catenation is nothing but it is the ability of the carbon atom to form a covalent bonding with the carbon atoms as well as other atoms like oxygen, sulfur, nitrogen, phosphorus or any of the halogens. Okay, for example CCl4, isn't it? One carbon atom has joined with the 4 Cl atom to form a carbon tetrachloride. Okay, and carbon has a unique property to join one atom to another atom to form a larger chain. Okay, like this we write. Okay, and this property cannot be exhibited by any other atoms except sulfur. Sulfur can hold the 4 more sulfur atoms, that's it. But the carbon chain, however bigger, we can form the carbon chain, no matter whatever the number of carbon atoms. Okay, this is the unique property of the carbon atom, which is called as catenation. Okay, and it can hold other carbon atoms to form a carbon chain, as well as it can hold its own carbon atoms also to form a carbon chain. Okay, and when the carbon can hold the other atoms like these atoms, and those are going to form a certain compounds by the covalent bonding between them. Okay, those compounds are called as organic compounds. Study of the analysis of those organic compounds, we are doing it in the chapter. Analysis of organic compounds and structure and shape of the organic compounds, and the hybridization and bonding between the organic compounds. And also in this chapter we are studying the isomerization in the organic compounds, and some of the effects like electromeric effect, resonance effect, and all we are studying here. Okay, at the end, qualitative and quantitative analysis of the elements, organic compounds is there, that is elements is there. I think that is being deleted from your syllabus. I'll check it out and clarify you later. Got it? Okay. Now let us begin with the chapter, Organic Chemistry, Some Basic Principles and Techniques. Yes, students. In this chapter, first we have to study the nature of pi bond and sigma bonds, how the pi and sigma bonds are formed. Okay, both are called, comes under the covalent bonds itself. Okay, there are bonds like a covalent bond, ionic bonding. Okay, more about this we will study in the another chapter, that is coordination chemistry in the second PUC. Okay, in the first PUC, one of the chapter called Chemical Bonding, there we will study it in detail. for this chapter with respect to that chapter we will discuss. See, carbon will form the covalent bond in A. Okay, carbon will form the, for example, ethylene halide CH2 double bond CH2 ethene molecule. Okay, between these two, okay, these CH2 means this CH2, two CHs are attached to this carbon atom in this. Okay, these many bonds are formed. Okay, in these many bonds, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 are called as sigma bonds. Remember, single bonds are always called as sigma bonds. Okay, and if carbon-carbon double bond is there, one will be sigma bonding, another one will be pi bonding. Remember, very basic concepts are. Okay, if carbon-carbon triple bond is there, okay, one will be sigma bonding and two will be pi bonding. Istana nivu nenpittu kobeku. Single bond idaga always it will be pi, sigma bond only. This is called sigma bond. If it is double bond, then one is sigma, one is pi. If it is triple bond, one is sigma, two are pi bonds. Okay, this you should be able to identify. Okay. Sigma bond. Sigma bond is formed due to the head-on overlapping of the orbitals. Orbitals will overlap. Orbital of this atom and orbital of this atom will overlap to form a bond. That is called as a sigma bonding. Okay? Sigma bond is formed due to the head-on overlapping of orbitals. Head-on overlapping of orbitals. Okay, pi bond. Pi bond is formed due to the sideways. Sideways overlapping. Sideways overlapping of orbitals. Okay, remember, and sigma bond is strong bond, pi bond is weak bond. Okay, why? Because it is formed by just the sideways overlapping of the orbital. Okay, if one p orbital, another p orbital is there. Okay, sigma bond is formed by the head on overlapping sigma bond, one pi bond and one p orbital, another p orbital. Okay, like this. One p orbital, another p orbital fall down like this. Head on overlapping when it happens, then sigma bond is formed. But pi bond is formed just due to the lateral overlapping or sideways overlapping. This is called as pi bond, this is called as sigma bond. Therefore, sigma bond is always strong and pi bond is always weak. Okay, and in the CH2, double bond CH2 molecule, in the ethene molecule, how is the structure of the ethene molecule? Carbon, double bond carbon, okay, hydrogen, 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 okay. These all atoms lie in the same plane. These all atoms lie in the same plane. But what is double bond is there? No. That is a pi bond. Pi bond is perpendicular. Pi bond is a perpendicular to the plane. If all the atoms are in the same plane, pi bond forms like this. Therefore, the pi bond is spreaded over, the electron cloud of the pi bond is spreaded over on the plane as well as below the plane. Above the plane as well as below the plane. You got it? Okay, this you should know. Okay, this is about the pi bond as well as sigma bond. Okay, how the pi bond is formed and which is stronger, why sigma bond is stronger, and when any compound is given, how many pi bonds are there, how many sigma bonds are there, you should be able to identify. Students, here I have written some exercise to you. Identify number of pi and sigma bonds. Okay, identify number of pi bonds and sigma bonds in the given examples. Okay, first example is what? It is ethane. Okay, here I write the answer. Okay, here it's a sigma bond, number of sigma bonds and number of pi bonds. Okay, to answer this question, we have to expand the structure, right? To this carbon atom, three hydrogen atoms are attached, and to this carbon atom, three hydrogen atoms are attached. We have already discussed that single bonded are called as sigma bonds. Therefore, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So, in this molecule, how many sigma bonds are there? 7 sigma bonds are there and no pi bonds. We'll move on to next. Okay, you tell me how many sigma bonds are there? 4 carbon atoms are attached to the single carbon atom. 4 hydrogen atoms are attached to the single carbon atom. Therefore, 4 sigma bonds are there and no pi bonds. Okay, and here 4 Cls are attached. I previously have to show you, isn't it? Therefore, 4 sigma bonds and no pi bonds. Here you tell me how many sigma bonds. See, I need not to show the bonding here. It is understood. CH I have written means there is a bond between C and H. So, 1 sigma bond, 2 sigma bonds. If triple bonded compound means what I told? 1 sigma bond, 2 pi. Isn't it? 1 sigma bond, 1, 2, 3. So, therefore, 3 sigma bonds and 2 pi bonds. Next. Next one, CH3 tries CH. Why I have written it? You should be able to expand it and write. See, CH is there. Okay, to the same carbon atom, 3 CH3s are attached. CH3. Okay, now we can find out the number of sigma bonds as well as pi bonds. See, here this carbon atom has a 3 bonds with a 3 hydrogen atom. Therefore, 3 plus 3 plus 3, 9 sigma bonds, okay, plus 1, 10 sigma bonds, 11, 12, 13. 3 plus 3 plus 3, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Yes or no? Therefore, this has 13 sigma bonds, but it has no pi bonds. Okay, see here how many sigma bonds are there. You just check it, calculate and tell me. Okay, here double bond is there, one is pi, one is sigma. Okay, here 3 sigma bonds, 3 sigma bonds, 3 plus 3, 6, 7, 8, 9, 9 sigma bonds and 1 pi bond. Okay, got it, no? These many examples I have written. In this, whatever molecule is given, you should know how to write the number of sigma bonds as well as number of pi bonds. Students, see, CH3, CH, double bond, C, double bond, CH2. Okay, in this compound, you calculate how many sigma bonds are there and how many pi bonds are there. Okay, sigma bonds, 1, 2, 3 sigma bond, 4, and expand the hand right. Is it not? Yes, this is the expanded structure. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So, 9 sigma bonds are there and 2 pi bonds are there. Yes, sir. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, I'm sorry, I'll just check it once. Okay, 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 sigma bonds and 2 pi bonds. Okay, now by judging the number of pi bonds and sigma bonds, one can decide their hybridization. What do you mean by hybridization? It is the intermixing of atomic orbitals. Intermixing of atomic orbitals to form new to form new hybrid orbitals with the same energy and shape is called as hybridization. Intermixing of atomic orbitals to form a new hybrid orbitals with the same energy and shape is called as hybridization. Much about the hybridization you will study in the chemical bonding chapter. Okay, so in this chapter we'll just study how to decide the hybridization of the carbon atom in a given compound. See, this is the shortcut method I will ask you to remember. Hybridization, write it. Okay, see, if the carbon atom contains 4 sigma bonds and no pi bonds, it is said to undergo sp3 hybridization. If 3 sigma bond, 1 pi bond, sp2 hybridization. If 2 sigma bonds, 2 pi bonds, sp hybridization. You have to write it in your notes. Okay, it is important and very easiest shortcut method to find out the hybridization of the carbon atoms in a given compound. Got it? You have to remember this. Now we'll take some examples. CH4. It is asked, it will be asked in the annual examination, find out the hybridization of the carbon atom in the given compounds. Okay? What is the hybridization of the carbon atom? Now we have to calculate the number of sigma bonds as well as pi bonds. How many pi bonds are there here? No pi bonds. How many sigma bonds? 4 sigma bonds. Therefore, this carbon is said to undergo sp3 hybridization. Okay? One s orbital and 3 p orbitals have overlapped to form 4 new sp3 hybrid orbitals. 4 new sp3 hybrid orbitals. Got it? Okay, let me write some more examples. Okay, dear students, here I have written some of the examples which are given in the NCERT text to decide their hybridization. And such questions are important for your annual examination. Okay, how they ask the question? Find out the hybridization of each carbon atom. Find out the type of hybridization of each carbon atom in the compound. They give like that. Okay. This one, first one, CH3Cl. Okay, they have asked only to find out the hybridization of the carbon atom. But here you don't consider this as a carbon. It is not carbon. Cl, chlorine it is. Okay, tell me what type of hybridization it is undergoing. CH3, 1, 2, 3, 3 sigma bond. Okay, and the C, carbon and chlorine is also bonded by the sigma bond itself. Therefore, 4 sigma bonds means here the carbon atom is undergoing sp3 hybridization. Next, CH3 twice CO. If you are getting confused, you can write it like CH3 C double bond O CH3. Okay. With respect to this carbon atom, I am talking. What is the hybridization of the first carbon atom? See, this carbon is bonded by the 3 hydrogen atoms with the 3 sigma bonds, and this is also single bond. Therefore, it is sigma bond. So, therefore, with respect to this carbon atom, it is sp3. Okay, I am writing here. sp3. Okay, and the second carbon atom is what hybridization it has? Single bond, single bond, single bond. These all are the sigma bonds. Therefore, 3 sigma bonds, 1 pi bond. 3 sigma, 1 pi. It is sp2. Okay, as CH3 twice in the same place they have written. No? So, these both CH3s are exhibiting sp3 hybridization. Next carbon atom is showing sp2 hybridization. So next one, methyl cyanide. Okay, you should know the structure to decide the hybridization. CH3 single bond, C triple bond N. We know that the valency of the carbon atom is 4. What do you mean by the valency? The capacity to hold the bonds. Carbon can hold 4 bonds. Okay, so therefore it has held only one bond here. So 3 more I have written to satisfy this valency of the carbon atom. So, this carbon atom, 3 sigma bonds, 4 sigma bonds. Therefore, the first carbon atom is sp3 hybridized. Second carbon atom, 1 sigma, 2 pi. Means 2 sigma, 2 pi. That is sp hybridization. Got it? Next, this one. See how it's structured? Hydrogen, to that carbon is attached, to that oxygen is attached, to that nitrogen, amine group is attached. Got it? Acetamine. Okay. What is the hybridization of this carbon atom? Sigma bond, sigma bond, sigma bond. 3 sigma bond, 1 pi bond. Then the hybridization of this one is, yes, 2. Next, this one. Okay, this at least we can say from here itself. CH3 means what it is? Yes, sp3 hybridization. CH. Okay? Only 1 pi bond is there. Therefore, it is sp2 hybridization. Here also only pi bond. Therefore, this carbon also exhibits sp2 hybridization. Here, as in the previous case, 2 pi bond, 2 sigma bonds. Therefore, it is sp hybridization. If you are getting confused, you can expand the structure, write it, and then you can count the number of carbon atoms, pi bonds as well as sigma bonds. Students, you have to be thorough in this. Okay, first we studied how to calculate the number of, how to find out the number of sigma bonds and pi bonds. Based on that, how to decide the hybridization of the organic organic carbon atom. Yes, students, here I have written one more information, that is hybrid type of hybridization, percentage of S character, and what is the shape of the molecule. Okay, see, if it is sp3 hybridization, what is the percentage of S character here? See, 1:3. Okay, in a 100, it takes 75, it is 25, yes or not? So, percentage of S character in this sp3 is 25, and it is tetrahedral in shape. Tetrahedral shape means, like this it is. Okay, next, sp2 hybridization means percentage of S character is 33%, and the shape is trigonal planar. Trigonal planar means like this. Okay, trigonal planar shape. Sp hybridization means 50-50, both are, therefore it will be linear in shape. For example, CH, triple bond, linear in shape. Okay, you have to remember this. Okay, write on this table and below you write. Increase in the percentage of S character increases the electronegativity of the carbon atom. If there is a more percentage of S character, means what? Percentage of S orbital is near to the nucleus. Okay, if the electrons are near to the nucleus, they are held more tightly by the nucleus. Therefore, the electronegativity increases. Increase in the percentage of S character increases the electronegativity of that carbon atom. So therefore, for example, out of ethane, ethene and ethyne, which is more electronegative in nature? Carbon atom with a triple bond is more electronegative, because carbon atom with a triple bond is sp hybridization. Then the S character is 50%, which are more electronegative. Got it? And this you should remember. Okay, if carbon-carbon single bond is there, we can easily rotate the molecule along the axis. If it is double bond or triple bond, the pi bond, due to the formation of pi bond perpendicular to the plane, there is a hindrance, there is a disturbance in rotating the molecule. Therefore, the double bonded and triple bonded carbon compound, carbon molecules cannot be rotated along the axis. This information also you should have. Okay, today this much is enough. Rest of the things we'll continue with the